Hivyo, welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 3, lesson number 7. The topic it is with Daddy. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson goals for today. We are going to look at the types of weathering, then the processes of mechanical weathering. What are the types of weathering? There are three types of weathering. As I mentioned in my previous lesson, I mentioned a number of them where we are looking at the agents and also the factors influencing them. We have the mechanical weathering, the chemical weathering, and biological weathering. So we are going to look at each at a time. Today we are going to look at the mechanical weathering. Mechanical weathering, it is also referred to as the physical weathering. So we can give it another name, physical weathering. It involves rock disintegration without any chemical change. Here there is no chemical change. It makes the rocks to break into smaller fragments. And it is common in arid and semi-arid areas. These ones we refer to them as the ASO areas. And high altitude areas that experienced marked variations in temperature. The mechanical weathering occurs in the following ways. These are now the processes of mechanical weathering or the processes of chemical weathering. One of the processes we refer to it as rock disintegration. It involves large blocks of rocks that breaks away from the original rock mass along joints and bedding planes. So that breaking down of the rocks around the joints or bedding planes, and this is commonly in areas that have large diurnal temperatures. That means it is in arid and semi-arid areas. There is how it looks like. Rock disintegration. As you can be able to see, that rock is breaking around the joints. So that is the reason as to why we refer to it as rock. And it is breaking in blocks. Okay, we go to the second process, which we refer to it as the exfoliation. In arid areas, rock surface heat up rapidly and expand when exposed to the high day temperatures. And during the day, the outer layer of the rock is more heated than the interior and expands more than the interior part. At night, when the temperatures fall, now when there is that temperature fall, the outer layers of the rocks cools and contracts while the inner layer is still warm. The rock cracks, spreads, peels off like an onion, a process known as the exfoliation. So during that process, one is more warmer than the other one. One is more, has more high temperatures than the other one. So that one results to the rock peeling off like an onion. That's how it looks like, as far as you can be able to see from the diagram. That rock has peeled off. And that what happens when it comes to that exfoliation. The third one, it is the granular disintegration. It is the breakup of rocks into small particles. It is common in coarse, grade, intrusive, igneous rocks. So this is specifically for the intrusive igneous rocks. It is caused by the alternate heating and cooling of the heterogeneous rocks. Heterogeneous means they are not of the same resistance. That's how it looks like. As far as you can be able to see, we have the granules, the grains. resulting to the formation of that rock. So they are removed from the rock at different rate. That is the reason as to why we refer to them as the granular disintegration, removal of the grains at different rates. We also have the fourth one, which is the frost action. Water enters the cracks and pore spaces in high mountain regions. This one now only takes place in high mountain regions. Low temperatures make the water to freeze into ice crystals, which grow in the cracks. As the crystals grow, pressure is exerted on the joints, thus widening the crack that will allow more to get in and freeze. Freeze and thaw action is repeated over time, making the outer part of the rock to break away and fall off. Then the other one, it is the pressure release. Deep-seated igneous rocks are under great pressure from the overlying rock layers. The upper part of the exposed rock expands slightly due to the reduced pressure. And this leads to the big shells of rock breaking away from the parent rock mass. Then we also have the crystal growth. During the long dry season, the water in the rock is drawn to the surface by the capillary action. High temperatures make the water to evaporate, depositing tiny particles of the salt in rocks and cracks and pores. The salt crystals accumulate and grow, exerting pressure and widening it. Eventually, the rock piece falls off. That's how the crystal grows. You can be able to see where we have the crystal. They are found in those areas. That's the result to the breaking of that rock. Then the other one, it is the slick. It is common in areas with alternate dry and wet season. In wet season, rocks with high clay content, and remember the rocks must contain the high clay content, absorb moisture and soil. In dry season, the particles lose much of this water, causing them to shrink. This alternate wetting and drying is repeated, causing individual rocks particles to become loosely attached and break off. Assignments, activity for today, explain four physical processes of the mechanical weathering, and then state three types of weathering. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 3, that edition, or you can get us through the SMS to the number. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. You can also get us or Twitter us through that. Otherwise, stay tuned to the Arena TV. Thank you.